Keith Mills has joined us here. This is quite a show, Keith.
Scott, you and I have seen a lot of things on baseball fields, but I don't think we've ever seen anything like this.
Home plate has been unearthed.
We're going to talk about your friend, Keith Mills. He's everybody's friend. He announced that he's semi-retired. He's not going anywhere. Keith Mills and Scott Garceau formed Baltimore's dynamic duo when it came to sports. And a couple of years ago, we sat around a table at Michael's 8th Avenue, and we placed a bet on how many names he would drop in his 15-minute acceptance speech into the Hall of Fame. If he had the over 256, you were kind of close. Keith Mills saw two Super Bowls. He saw Kenny Cooper in his Baltimore Blast. He saw one of the great Preakness runs of all time, Easy Goer and Sunday Silence. And of course, he saw the Maryland Terps win it all, the national championship. So the lacrosse, all the high school sports he brought right into your living room. And Millsy was quite the character too. But the biggest event that we can all remember was the last day at Memorial Stadium. And we thought we'd bring it back one more time.
You know, it's hard to believe. I can still remember opening day when people saying, well, it's still a good ways away. We've got a lot of time to get ready for this. And, you know, still mentally, I think a lot of people aren't ready for it.
And there's where it was. Home plate as we knew it. Now just kind of a hole in the ground. And you see the cameras rolling.
I sort of hope.
Constant through all the years, Ray, has been baseball. America has rolled by like an army of steamrollers. It's been erased like a blackboard, rebuilt and erased again. But baseball has marked the time. This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good. And it could be again.
Number five.
Just seeing him in the uniform. It's awesome.
I don't think they had to tell him where to go either. I think he knew the way.
He can still pick the two hopper up right now and fire it first. You know, Scott, one thing an athlete never loses is the mannerisms that went along with his persona. Brooks with the shuffle around third, Frank with the trot coming up right here. How many times have we seen him make this trot around the bases on a home run?
Number 20, and you see the tears streaming down the eyes of a fan of Frank and Brooks and all the other Orioles. Made so great, many great memories here at Memorial Stadium. Frank out to right field. He said the Orioles were a great team. When Frank came, they found out how to win. 1966, he showed up and they won their first championship. Managed this team, now as assistant general manager.
If you don't have a chill right now, you're not an Orioles fan.
Here comes the big guy and the big boog. Listen to it. Voted by you fans as the all-time Oriole first baseman, and people would say, well, gee, it wasn't greater than Eddie Murray, and I think Boog would tell you probably not on the field, but Boog was a very popular guy. To meet him is to love him. He's got a bad knee, but Jim Palmer will make his way to the mound. Jim's going to have surgery. The Cy Youngs having trouble holding back the emotion. Hit Cooperstown last year. Jim Palmer's crying out on the mound.
Don Baylor.
The Groove. Don Baylor, who soon could be a manager in the major leagues. A lot of reports out of Milwaukee say that he could take over that club next year.
You know, Scott, Don Baylor and Bobby Gritsch basically came up at the same time and really sort of represented the new guard of the Orioles in the early 70s. And it's a shame the Orioles fans didn't really get a chance to see him play more. Rick Dempsey.
Oh, yeah, he came back. His team closed out the season, but he thought it was important to be in Baltimore today. The Brewers gave him permission to be here. And if you look at the numbers, you'd say this guy wasn't so great, but he was everything that Oriole fans wanted him to be. He'd get dirty and he'd throw his body in the way. MVP of the 83 World Series, Rick Dempsey. And there's Davey Johnson, I believe.
Davey Johnson, Bobby Gritsch.
Oh yeah.
Right behind him.
Two second basemans.
Oh. Richie Tower. Unfortunately just let go by Cleveland, but what a solid player he was here.
One of the three stooges that had a lot of fun in 83.
Hall of Famer Luis Aparicio.
Little Louie, what a tradition of shortstops the Orioles have had. Even prior to Louie.
Willie Miranda, Billy Hunter.
Mark Belanger.
Mark Belanger.
Here comes the blade. Number seven.
You can still picture him going deep in the hole, jumping up in the air, throwing a ball to first.
Still at his same playing weight, I believe.
Right.
Here comes the big bopper. Lee May.
He was the Cecil Fielder of his day.
Lee always tells Brooks, I made you what you are. He hit half those balls in 70.
The Reverend.
Pat Kelly headed for left field. Here's a man who's worn the Oriole uniform in more games than anybody. Over 1,700 games in the Oriole uniform. And boy, there's the emotion. Elrod Hendricks. See him next year. He'll be down at Oriole Park in Camden Yards.
You know, Scott, class has been symbolized in this organization for so many years.
Oh, the left field combination, Keith.
Yes, they are.
Were they fantastic? Rick Dempsey and Elrod with their arms across each other, but the two-headed left fielder, Lowenstein and Renicky.
And virtually every person here being introduced is the epitome of class, just class personality. Dave McNally.
Talked to him before the game, right?
One of his fondest memories, the grand slam he hit. In the 1970 World Series.
Pat Dobson, one of four 20-game winners the Orioles had in the same season. And there he is, Crazy Horse,
Mike
Cuellar. Had a chance to golf with him last week. He was in for Jim Palmer's tournament.
You know, Mike Flanagan was telling a story that Mike Cuellar really helped him out, understanding the major league way to pitch when he first came up. Doug DeSensei.
Left here and had some brilliant years with the Angels, and nobody will ever forget the home run he hit here in 79. Doug and Brooks in third. He had to follow Brooks's act.
Diamond Jim Gentile, number four. Still a huge, for the fans of the 50s and early 60s, he's one of the most popular players.
The first gigantic star was Jim Gentile, the year he had in 61. Russ Snyder headed out for right field. And here he comes again. Mike Flanagan, listen to the hand.
I don't think anyone in this stadium appreciates this day more than Mike Flanagan.
Oh, Flanny. You know, Millsy was right that nobody enjoyed that day more than Mike Flanagan. You know, we were just at Keith's retirement party this past Saturday. I ran into a young lady, And I said, well, what brings you out here? And she said that her son played for Keith while Keith was a coach at Cardinal Gibbons coaching baseball. And then her husband passed away and her son was getting married. And she asked Keith to walk her down the aisle on her son's wedding day. That's the kind of guy Keith Mills is. That's why Keith Mills is our friend.